Right then, so it says the second term in a geometric sequence is 4. So I know that U2 is 4. I know the fourth term is 8, so I know that U4 is 8. So I know what the common ratio. So I know that 4 is A, hang on, there's an equal sign. I know that 4, because it's the second term, is AR. I know that 8, because it's the fourth term, is AR cubed. Now there's lots of different ways of doing it. I'm just a little bit sneaky. I'm going to sub that into there. So I'm going to see that as AR times by R squared. But AR is 4 from there. So 2 is R squared. Oops, forgot that. So R is plus or minus root 2 for R. Now it tells me that R is greater than 0, so as R is greater than 0, therefore R is now positive root 2. How much of room have you used up there? So that's my common ratio done. So I might miss off part B, part C, sorry. So part B says find the first term, so I find A. But I know that 4 is AR, so I know that 4 is A times root 2. So we'll put like a little sneaky bit here. So 4 over root 2 is A. So 1 over root 2 is root 2 over 2. So that's going to be 2 root 2 for A. Is that right? That's right. And then the last one is the 10th term. So U10 is a 2 root 2 times by a 2 to the power of 9. So it'll be 2 to the 10 root 2. Oh no, it's root 2, isn't it? There. So I'll be sticking in the calculator. It'll be 2 times by root 2 to the power 10, which is a 2 to the 5. It's going to be a 2 to the 6. 6 to 4. There. I'm not sure if you've got that one then. And then I've got this one. Right. So I've got 3. Going to x, so I multiply by r, and then it goes to x plus 6, so I multiply by the same r. Now the r value, the ratio, is one number divided by its previous number. So for these two, I'll do it a different colour so it stands out. For these two, r is x over 3, because it's the one divided by its previous. For these two, r is x plus 6 over x, but they're the same number, so that kind of tells you that x over 3 is x plus 6 over x. So if I do a little cross multiplying, I get x squared is 3 lots of the bracket, and then I've got x squared minus 3x minus 18 is 0. Were you happy with that being the 3 lots of the bracket? Oops. And then if I solve it, it gives me x is 6, or x is minus 3. So it has to be positive, doesn't it? It's going between 3. So it would be the one that worked for it. Otherwise, no. Or you could have like a 3 and a minus 3. And then a 3 is just multiplied by minus 1, couldn't it? So both of those work. Different sequences. So if it was a plus 6, that's a 6, you'd have a 3, 6, 12, so doubling it. Or if you have minus 3, it's a 3 minus 3, 3 minus 3, 3 minus 3, 3 minus 3, multiplied by minus 1. B says find the 10th term. I'll just say positively, don't I? So the positive one would be using x is 6. So that would mean then that our R value is 6 over 3, which is 2, which I need. So I want the 10th term now. So U10 is A, which was 3, times by 2 to the power of 9, which is 15 36. Hopefully that kind of makes sense. It seems to, hopefully. Right, there's an exam question on the next page, so we'll give that a blast. If it'll turn over. It's not working. Here we go. Right, so, maybe I need to do some more talking to this one now. Let's give it a go. So Sarah's carrying out a series of experiments which involve using increasing the same amount of chemicals. In the first experiment, she uses 6 grams. And in the second, she uses 7.8. So part one says, given that it's an AP, so it's like a 6 and then a 7.8, so then that would tell me that A is 6 and D is 1.8. Find the total amount of chemical used in the first 30 experiments. And it's 30. So is it the total? So what am I after here now? Now I want the total amount of chemical used. So I'm not asked the amount of chemical used in the 30th. I'm actually after the total amount of used so far. So I'm after the sum. So the sum of 30. So remember, it's n over 2, 2n plus n minus 1d for the sum. So the sum of the 30 terms is 30 over 2, 2 lots of 6, 30 minus 1 lots of 1.8. So sum of 30 is going to give us 963 according to the completed pack. So that's part one done. Part 2 says, oh hang on, it's not an AP, it's a GP. So part 2 says, so if it's a GP, then A is 6, and R is 7.8 over 6, which is 1.3. There. Okay, so then I want the sum of the 30 there, don't I? Oh no, hang on. Let me read the question. So instead, it's given that the amounts of chemical are a geometric progression. Sarah has a total of 1,800 grams of chemicals left. Show that that's the greatest number. So this is a sum, isn't it? Right, can be satisfied by that equation. Oh look, I've got to get that. Right, so what do we know then? So R is 1.3, so I use the sum of N. It's A, R to the N minus 1 over R minus 1. And I'm looking for less than 1,800, aren't I? How about the sum to n to be less than or equal to 1,800 grams? Let's put it a bit of A. So my A was 6. R is, what was it, 1.3? So yeah, minus 1 over 1.3 minus 1 is less than or equal to 1,800. I'm going to divide 3 by the 6, I get 300 there, won't I? So 1.3 to the minus 1 over 0.3, so it'll be less than or equal to 300. Multiply through by the 0.3 is going to give me a 90. I don't need that bracket. So 1.3 to the minus 1 is less than or equal to 90. So 1.3 to the n is less than or equal to 91. Ta-da! Got that. So that's okay. And then it says use logs. I could use log to base 1.3, or I could just use logs. But it's up to you which way you do it. So if I use log to base 1.3, then n is less than or equal to log to base 1.3 of 91. If I didn't do that, which you've got to be careful with sometimes, I'd have an ln of 1.3 to the n, less than or equal to ln of 91. So n ln 1.3 less than or equal to ln 91. N less than or equal to ln 91 over ln 3. About 1.3. And it'd get me the same answer. Right, which is that n is less than or equal to 17.19. So n is 17. And that's that one done. Both that's good, so I can stop there for that one and start a new one.